Hi everyone, welcome back. Today we will continue the series about the leadership, and we have a very important rule for leadership today we want to talk about, which is how we can chisel our foundation to success as a leader. First of all, the most important thing when we are, you know, building really high building or great building, if you want to name it like that, is to have a suitable foundation for this building. So if you are making one floor or just a very simple structure, we don't need that much of foundation to do that. But if you are thinking about making something great, we are thinking about making the suitable foundation for this one. So in this regard, if we want to implement that for the leadership, the most important thing as a foundation for leadership is the trust. Here, credibility and trust are the main bones for this kind of or the backbone for the whole hierarchy for this leadership that we think that we need to build as a great leader or a good leader. Definitely, we are building that step by step when we are really making our character with our people that we are dealing with. This is why the idea or the concept of the character, which is coming from the Latin word, that's something really chiseled, to make a character mean chiseled this way, or remove this from the plane or the area or this kind of paper or whatever where you are writing that. You are chiseling your way to make a specific character, and bit by bit, head by head, for your chisel, when you are making this, you are making this shape of the character. So this kind of trust is built from the beats and nuts and the small things you are doing every day with your team, every day with yourself, every day with all the surroundings that you are dealing with on a daily basis. This means that a good leader or a great leader need to have a vision. This is why we can see one of the artists like Michelangelo or others, really they have seen this kind of great status that they are creating out of this marble. Even when the marble is just as a cube, you can see this kind of stone as just as a simple stone, or this marble as a marble without having a sense what could be done out of that. But he, as artist, he can see inside this one this great status or the great angle that he need really to just remove or chisel the small stones around it, just to show you what he imagined inside. The leader is doing the same. He can imagine a great idea about you, himself and the others, and his job and to do to himself, chisel what is really needed to be removed out of his character to show you his greatness, and also do the same for the remaining part of his team. This will lead us to a very slightly complicated issue, which is talking about the success or the formula of success. The great leader or a good leader should have a clear idea what he means by success, because there is a lot of people are talking about different formulas for success, but here I just one of the my best formulas that I really rely on it and believe in it, which is saying that the success equals your character multiplied by your skills multiplied by your attitude multiplied by your relationship. And really, this is each and every part of this formula can contribute greatly to really maximize the value, or even have a bad impact if there is a drop in one of those items here. So think about it, you as a great leader or a good leader to your team, you should think that you need to develop each and every part of this formula in order to have a great team, a great leadership behavior, and also a great model for your team. This is very important, and we should also keep this in our mind, because if you manage to multiply everything and put everything on the highest possible, you can achieve the primary greatness, as Stephen Covey really made this concept in one of his books, The Primary Greatness. He said that you need humility and courage in order to really achieve this kind of being great rather than looking great, which is a big difference between both. So in summary, what I can tell you here out of that, in terms of action that you can take away, first of all, I want you to think about how you can really be credible in our walk the talk, and simply they call that, it is DWYSYWD, which is the acronym for do what you said that you will do. Very simple, when you promise someone to do something, please do it. as you promised, or be clear that why you did not do it, to be honest with him, to keep your credibility on the maximum level between yourself and your team. The second thing also, I want you to think about your vision, how you have this kind of courage to remove or chisel whatever comes in your way to show your greatness as a leader, and also do the same, help the other to really also have the effort and courage to remove whatever is there between them and their greatness. The third thing that I want you to think about is, what is your success formula? If you can just write down this formula and ask yourself, if you have a problem with one of your team or one of your member, if you are not achieving a success in any area of your life, ask about it. What is my character in this domain? What is the needed skills there? Can I improve them? What is my attitude with this guy or inside my team or inside my organization? Do you really stand for the values that I believe in or not? What is how healthy it is my relationship with all the people, that the key people contributing to my success? This is also a good question that you can start asking yourself in order to build achieve the maximum value out of this success formula. This was what I have for you today. I hope that you find this kind of tip useful, and I will be waiting for you in the next tip, number 4, to talk about another main concept about leadership. See you there. Bye.